Afternoon, everyone. When we recorded this Mass, it was a little time constraint for us, so basically I didn't have the time to really pray and reflect on the Gospel when we had recorded the Mass. So what I'm actually going to do is just say a few words now about the Gospel, because when you continue to watch the Mass, obviously we would go right into the Creed. You know, Jesus tells us in today's Gospel to take up your cross and follow me. Of course, you have Peter who's trying to rebuke him in some way, trying to sit there and not have Jesus talk about facing the cross. But Jesus tells us, take up your cross and follow me. And immediately when we hear that, of course we think of the burdens that we have, that we take them on ourselves, and that somehow when we do that, we're being faithful followers. And there's certainly a reality to it. You know, we look at our situations, whatever burdens we're carrying. You know, there's a reality when we really say, it's a cross for me to bear, but out of love for Jesus Christ, I will take up that cross and follow him. But there's also another underlying piece in this, is Jesus is really asking us to fall in love with him. It's an underlying theme, of course, we have throughout the Gospel, but especially in this passage that may seem a little bit odd. Jesus is saying, take up your cross and follow me. One of the great realities that we preach about in marriage is wanting the good of the other, and that's part of our love of neighbor. But especially for married couples, to sit there and say, I really want what's best for the other person at all times. It's part of falling in love. It's part of building that relationship. So when Jesus is telling us to take up our cross and follow him, he's sitting there and saying, not just your reality that may be a negativity, but more importantly, will the good of me the same that I will the good of you? We think about our relationship with Jesus, with God. He's telling us all the time, how much he wants the good for us, how much he wants to make us into the people that we could really be, to really become his disciples and to spread his word. He's looking for us at moments to no longer sin, to become better and better each day. Every single action is willing the good, but willing the good so that we can build that relationship with him. So as we reflect upon this Gospel, we should really ask ourselves, when I take up my cross and I follow him, am I really just trying to say, I'm trying to fall more in love with Jesus Christ? I'm trying to build that relationship by letting everything that stands in the way of it go away. It's a way to look at the Gospel as not just in a negative light, but more importantly, what is standing in the way of building that relationship? Taking up a cross is a beautiful thing. Taking up our cross for Jesus Christ is our way of showing our love for him, our way of building our relationship with him, our way of saying, Lord, you want the good for me always, and I want to bring the good in our relationship just the same. So God bless you each and every day, and God bless you all this weekend especially. Amen, and have a great day.
Hello and welcome to St. Ambrose. Join us as we sing our opening song, We Are Called.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you,
We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you had nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I'm an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. Oh, and I will always praise you. In the shadow of your wings I cling to you, and you hold me high. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you,
from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed on the third day, be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct." The Gospel of the Lord. And so let us stand and together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and is spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In gathering with one heart and one voice, we now bring our prayers and petitions before the Lord. We pray that Christ may visit his holy church and keep watch over her always. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray that Christ may fill the Pope, all bishops, the order of bishops, all priests, deacons, and lay ministers with spiritual gifts and graces. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That under the protection of Christ, our times may always be times of peace. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all of our family and friends who are sick, for all those who are affected by COVID-19, and all the first responders, and all those in the health community. May the healing presence of Christ come down and work through them and with them. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all those we've been asked to pray for, and for those throughout the world who have no one to pray for them. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all of our family and friends who have died, may they rest forever in the peace of Christ. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty, ever-living God, who brings salvation to all and desire that no one should perish, hear the prayers of your people and grant that the course of our rule may be directed by your peaceful rule and your church rejoice in tranquility and devotion. For we ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Claim you as my choice. Be still.
And so let us stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to the Lord our God. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as together without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Edward our Bishop, Howard our Bishop Emeritus, all the clergy, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you and our neighbor through Christ our Lord. And together we make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you, and we pray this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever and ever. The Mass is ended. Let us go in love and peace to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. And I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save me.